Hey guys, it's Lika. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my... August wrap-up. I only read 6 books in the month of August. Now I know that's usually a pretty good number to read, but I tend to read more, so I was feeling a little bit slumpy during the month of August, but I am pretty happy with the 6 books that I've read, so let's just get into it. The first 2 that I read were Silence and Finale. These are the 3rd and 4th books in the Hush Hush series. I read these with Melissa over at Melissa and Barnsey Read. This was the conclusion to the Hush Hush, the quad thing? It's 4 books in the series. So it was a conclusion to that, and it was really good. Really, really good. I know a lot of people on BookTube read maybe the 1st or the 2nd one, but they don't pick up these 2. And you should. You really should reread the series and at least finish it. It's so worth it. It really is. I don't really want to talk about it without spoilers, but the Hush Hush series is about a girl who falls in love with a fallen angel. And there are so many twists and turns in this series that by the end of the book, you're just like, how in the hell did we get here? I don't know how, but it's awesome. I also read The Unexpected Everything by Morgan Matson. I buddy read this with Sylvia Kay. I'll go ahead and I'll link her channel down below as well. This book was cute. For a contemporary, it's really long. It's about 500 pages. So I do think that this story was about 200 pages too long because it was slow in some parts. The first 100 pages was just horrible for me to get through. Once I reached the 100 page mark, it started to get really cute. I do love Clark as a character. I love all the dogs. And it ended up being a cute story. Her father was a politician and there was some sort of scandal. And it was resolved in the story, but it wasn't like a resolution that satisfied me. I felt like the political scandal just kind of concluded poorly. I love Morgan Matson. I loved Second Chance Summer. This one, though, I feel like is not her best work. Then I read Secrets of Skin and Stone. This was the book choice in the read-along group that Melissa has. I'll go ahead and link that down below as well. This is a self-published book. And I know with self-published books, they're kind of hit or miss. Like, you either like them, they're really good, or they're just meh, they're so bad. This one was actually really good. This was about a gargoyle he is a man who shapeshifts into a gargoyle, and he moves into this town called Hidden Creek because there's like a lot of mysterious things going on over there. He's helping to protect the town and to figure out what the hell is going on. And he ends up falling in love with a resident named Piper. And Piper is a cutter, so there is a trigger warning in this book for people who are cutters. He kind of helps her through her cutting issues and helps her to believe in herself and to take her nightmares away. I recommend this book to anyone who may be interested in the gargoyle aspect of it. I also read Hearts We Sold. This was the book that we got in our owl crate. I went ahead and buddy read this with Melissa at Melissa and Barnsey Read. This is about a girl who comes from a family of alcoholics, chooses to go to a prep school to escape her home life. She realizes that she doesn't have enough money to go back to school for the next year to re-enroll, and she knows that her parents aren't going to help her. So she ends up trading her heart, or renting it, for 2 years to a demon in order to get money to go to school. I know it seems pretty superficial, but the story itself is really deep. The concept of the demons in here, like, they're pretty known. Like, people will trade their body parts for wishes. Demons aren't really who they seem. There are voids in the world that are allowing creatures to come in and destroy the planet. The demons want to close these voids. They're enlisting the help of people and to do so, but the people are unaware of what's going on. If you want to see a more in-depth review, then please let me know down in the comment section and I'll review this. I also read Fangirl by Rainbow Rowell. I also buddy read this with a friend. I read this with Zlata over at Matilda Gothica. I'll link her channel down below. I guess this month was a month of buddy reads for me because I was so slumpy. This is about a girl named Kath and she has a twin sister named Ren, so twins like Catherine. They live with their father and their mother walked out on them when they were 8 years old. Kath writes fan fiction for Simon Snow, which is Carry On. That's her fan fiction. And Carry On is like a parody of Harry Potter. This story was kind of hard for me to get through. It was hard for me to get into. And when it did pick up, it just kind of disappointed me again. The first month that Kath was in school, she wouldn't even go to the cafeteria to eat food. She just ate protein bars because of her social anxiety. I mean, I understand people have social anxieties. I have anxiety really bad, but you need to eat. Go to the cafeteria and eat, or at least walk down the street and find a McDonald's. You have to eat. Don't starve yourself. Kitty. Vlada ended up doing a really good rant review of this book, and I agree with a lot of her points, so I'll go ahead and I'll link that either on the screen or in the description box below. Thank you all for watching my August wrap-up. If you like this video, then please leave me a thumbs up, and if you don't want to miss any more videos from me, then please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!